Yeah, the one more question is like for this DevOps master course, so what exactly it's cover means in which area we can then go back doing this certification DevOps master?
Okay, so there is a question from Urmila. So DevOps master certification, basically what it covers. Now I covered or touched based upon the few of the concepts which are related to DevOps, like understanding the flow, the feedback loop, and the continuous experimentation. Now the questions in this certifications are basically testing your understanding of DevOps. Now if you are a DevOps master who is a decision maker who needs to decide how the DevOps is going to be implemented, what actions you are required to be to take. Let's say that you are given a scenario. Many times the questions are scenario based. There are around 50 questions and you have to score 33 or more to pass. Now these questions are basically testing your knowledge in terms of implementing DevOps or taking actions on the DevOps scenarios. So they will give you a describe a scenario that company XYZ wants to implement DevOps, but these are the challenges which they are facing. What's the best course of action to take in this situation? Okay, as per DevOps. Or the question might be related to few of the tools which I described, or deployment pipeline. So what is the best course of action to take in case the release is planned this way? It's auto to there are different ways in which you can put the release into the deployment server. It's automated to like push pull approach. So there might be questions on that offer. So in the certification course, I cover all these concepts. So questions are based on this concept.